Welcome to part 7 of your physical geography online class. This part introduces chapter 18, which is Aeolian geomorphology, or how does wind shape the Earth's surface? We find that what best introduces this topic is looking at regions of aridity, which are deserts. So we'll learn a little bit about deserts in this unit itself. We'll introduce some of the features that are found by erosion, transportation, and deposition yet again. So we'll start off discussing, well, where are deserts found? What correlations do we have within their location? We'll learn that there is a correlation with their line of latitude. We'll find that there's a correlation of deserts and topography. Perhaps remember orographic lift and the rain shadow effect mentioned in an earlier unit. We'll discuss that again. We'll also discuss really the relationship of where the desert is and relation to the ocean, continentality. Where is that in relationship to large bodies of water? So wind obviously is the driving force of our weather. It's because of the uneven heating of our Earth's surface, which kind of evolves this idea of motion of wind. But wind can move material three ways. It can move it by either saltation, which is about 50% of the way that material is moved. Saltation is really when a grain is in motion and it impacts the surface, it dislodges other material and transports that. It can also deal with what we consider creep, which is like a bed load, which is the material that's too large to bounce or to be floating around, and it rolls along the bottom. Or we can have suspension, which is where material, usually fine grains, silts, and clays, that become airborne and float very large distances. So we'll talk a little bit about that wind erosion. Most of that erosion occurs because of saltation, and therefore the deposition that we identify afterwards. Probably the most common form of deposition that you would know from these type of regions would be sand dunes. We will introduce 6 different types of sand dunes that are most commonly found within the U.S. There are others, but you'll do the top 6. We'll look at bark and dunes. We'll look at parabolic dunes, transverse dune, barkanoid ridge, and we'll also then be looking at other different types of features that can be then caused by the deflation or removal of material, such as blowouts. We'll also reintroduce some features that are found in river environments, such as alluvial fans and bajadas. You know, what's interesting is that when we think about the desert, we have to remember that the deserts are always dry, but they're not always hot. We classify deserts based off of their precipitation. So we have extremely arid, we have arid and semi-arid. So we look at these values of precipitation. It's not necessarily temperature, because it is not uncommon for you to go to Death Valley in the summer and it'd be over 125 degrees Fahrenheit. But you could also go during winter and it can be at below zero. It could be below freezing in many instances in Death Valley. So sure, we can have this very large fluctuation of temperature, but at the end of the day, Death Valley is always dry, receiving about 2 inches of rain per year. So again, kind of relating to the previous unit, I like to envision an environment, a place that I've been to these topics. So I like to relate this type of information, deserts in particular, looking at Death Valley, which is part of the Great Mojave Desert. Death Valley is also a national park. If you haven't had a chance, I highly suggest visiting during the spring, not during the summer. So some of the objectives, again, that you'll be walking through is, what are the classifications of deserts? What is the mode of transportation in which material can move by wind? Then we'll also then look at the features that have been left behind, either through erosion, transportation, or deposition. So that being said, I hope you enjoy this chapter. My master's thesis dealt predominantly with Aeolian environments. Real quick, I won't bore you with it, because when they say that, have you counted 1 million grains of sand, I can say I've counted more than that. I was looking at the material that was moving within a dune field in the eastern Sierra of California. It's the Keeler Dune Complex. And I sifted and I counted millions of grains of sand, to the point that it wasn't just, because sand, to kind of back up, is not a particular type of grain. It's just the size. So it doesn't matter what it's made out of, because as we learned in our beach introduction and unit, coastal environments can be made of all kinds of different types of rocks, the sand and beaches. It's whatever is more local. So it can be quartz and feldspars, it can be basalt, it can be different types of marble or even seashells. So I counted all these grains of sand, and then I counted things that were so small that I had to use a laser particle analyzer that shot a bright red beacon of light in a laser in a glass of water and counted the little microns of material and told me what it was made out of, looking at its geological composition. So I looked at that, which was actually quite interesting, and then also looked at the wind progression. I found that in the sand dune that I was studying, that the winds change, they're bidirectional. And that being said, that 6 months out of a year they blow northward, 6 months they blow southward, and in doing so can really change the environment. It changes the types of dunes. They have reversing dunes, which just means that at one part of the year they're moving as a crescent shape northward, then they change backwards, and they go back and forth throughout the course of an entire year. So they migrate. They don't really ever go anywhere. They pretty much stay within their little bubble of their home. So that was really interesting for myself to study. I had the choice. I could either study areas that were arid, or I could study areas of water, and I chose to deal with the heat than to deal with mosquitoes and mud. So I still think I made the better choice, even though I counted way too many grains of sand. Nonetheless, I hope you enjoy this topic, and we will talk soon.